Welcome back to the channel, my friends. All right, today we're going for the first run in the Reebok Forever Floatride Energy 2.0. I haven't run in Reeboks in a long time. No, I take that back. I have never run in Reeboks. I haven't worn Reeboks since I was a teenager, back in the day when we had these gorgeous Reebok pumps. And do you remember the Hexalite when it had that little window and you could see the hexagonal air pocket inside the shoe? So what did I think of these shoes? Let's get into the video and find out. Guys, my name's Matt. I post new videos every Monday and Friday. It's always about running. If you like this type of content, subscribe to the channel, give the video a thumbs up if you like it, and hit that bell icon so you're notified every time I drop a new video. All right, let's get into it. Guys, bit of a soaker for the first run in these Reebok Forever Floatride Energy 2.0. It's 77 degrees out, or 25 degrees Celsius with 86% humidity. I am soaked through. These shoes are gonna have to be stuffed with newspaper right away. How about some run stats? 10.4 miles or 16.737 kilometers at an average pace of 7.56 a mile or 4.56 a kilometer. All right. These shoes held up pretty well. Let's get inside and I'm gonna tell you all about them. In a nutshell, these shoes felt really good and I like the way they look. So what's the update? The update from last year, the Forever Floatride version 1, the only thing they changed was the upper. They've also gone back to this Vector logo, which I think looks pretty sharp. It's a lot better than that Delta logo they've had for the last couple years. I think this is a pretty sharp looking shoe. I expected it to be super soft. This Floatride foam, it looks and feels super cushiony. So when I first put the shoes on, they felt great. It's just got a good quality feel to it. I'm gonna lean in and just show you. Look at this tongue. The tongue is pretty thick. It's gusseted, so it's tied on the sides. And look how thick this padding is on the back. Heel counter, nice and firm, just like we want. All that padding, you know, it made me think, this is gonna be a pretty plush shoe. All right, I'm gonna put my foot in here, it's gonna feel like slipping into, a slipper, all right? Not the case. This shoe was not as obviously cushy as I thought it was going to be. After the first mile, I realized this shoe is not cushy. It feels pretty responsive, which is really, it was a really pleasant surprise, all right? You don't want a shoe that's too cushy. As the run went on, now listen, today was an easy run, so I was running pretty easy for most of it. I did pick up the speed as I went over a hill. Now when I say hill, I don't want anyone getting the wrong idea. I just ran up it. Can you see it behind me? It's a bridge over a pedestrian overpass. These are hills in my area of Florida. All right, I had to throw that in there just so you don't think that I'm some hill runner. I'm a flatlander all the way. I also did a couple of pickups. I did 8 pickups. They're only 30 seconds each, but my point was to test this shoe and to find out how it felt going a bit faster than I usually run. Now this shoe is marketed as a neutral daily trainer, and I think that is exactly the spot where it hits. The upper is an engineered mesh. It's an engineered mesh. Listen, that feels lovely. It feels high quality. And I only mention high quality because this shoe is very inexpensive. In fact, I'd say this is a budget shoe from Reebok. So my expectations were pretty low. Were my expectations met? You better believe it. This shoe was fantastic. I already told you I was expecting a really plush ride and I got something a little more responsive. So I would say on the continuum of plush to responsive, this shoe is somewhere in the 60 to 70% range towards responsive, a lot more responsive than I thought it would be. I already told you I was expecting a really plush ride and I got something a little more responsive. So I would say on the continuum of plush to responsive, this shoe is somewhere in the 60 to 70% range towards responsive, a lot more responsive than I thought it would be. How is Reebok making this shoe so inexpensive? Well, I think ultimately it comes down to the midsole material. All those super fast running shoes are going to use a PBAX-based foam. Nike Zoom X is a great example, but it's not very resilient. The Reebok Floatrun Energy uses a steam-molded TPE beads. TPE stands for thermoplastic elastomer. So that's how they get the cost savings down. The shoe is pretty light. It says it weighs in at 9 ounces for a men's size 9. And you can see here that my men's size 12 is 10.5 ounces. This shoe, super flexible. Look at this, you can bend it like a pretzel. Obviously, no carbon fiber plate inside, but that's not what this shoe is for. This shoe is not designed to compete with the super fast racers. This is a daily trainer through and through. It was super comfortable and responsive when I was running easy, and I totally forgot about it when I picked up the pace in order to do those short pickups that I was doing, and when I was running up the bridge. And the toe off is super smooth. It rolls nicely from the midfoot to the forefoot and off. Now let's talk about a few things that I'm not crazy about. The laces. Okay, these laces, let me just get up close so I can show you. They're round, they're hollow. I didn't have to retie the laces when I went out, so that's a huge plus. But you'll notice on the video when I was tying my shoes, they were just a little too short. I know I'm grasping at straws that the laces were a little too short. It made no difference to the run. It was just different than I've seen with other running shoes. Is it gonna be a problem? No. Now here's something very important. This is what I want you to listen to if you're considering buying these. Sizing was a little off. Reebok, at least recently, have been notorious for making a longer toe box. Usually I wear a men's size 13 in the US, size 12 in the UK, and I found there was just too much space at the end. Now it felt comfortable everywhere else, but there was just too much space for me to run comfortably. Luckily, I ordered a size 12 as well, and this fit a lot more. Now when I put the 12s on, it was a little tighter. It was a little tighter around my toes, especially my little toe on the outside. And I did feel it when I first went running. It was tight enough where I could feel the upper on my little toe, but not too tight. Still felt really good. And the length in the front was just perfect. There was plenty of room in the toe box for my toes to move around. Overall, it felt pretty good. I mentioned the heel counter earlier being super firm. There was nothing bad about this heel. In fact, it locked my heel in. As far as the drop goes, we got a pretty big drop. 10 millimeters, 19 millimeters in the forefoot, 29 in the heel. Resilience. How long do I think these shoes are gonna last? Well, let me show you the outsole. We have rubber along the whole outsole. I think Reebok would have put this rubber outsole on the whole outsole to give it a little continuity, make the ride a little smoother, and to give it some durability. This shoe is gonna last. This outsole rubber is pretty thick. Check back in a couple weeks. I will do the full review after 100 miles of running in this shoe. Let's talk about who I think this shoe is good for. It's gonna sound like a cop-out, but I'm gonna say everyone. This is a budget shoe. So if you're on a budget, this is a no-brainer. If you could only buy one pair of running shoes and you're on a budget, this is the shoe for you. It's soft enough that you can run a lot of miles, and it's responsive enough that it could double as a race day shoe. If you've never tried Reebok, try this. It's so inexpensive, you really got nothing to lose. And it's another shoe for your rotation, another shoe for you to expand your shoe horizons. This is a pretty well-kept secret, and I don't know why. I don't know why more people aren't running in this shoe. I've only run 10 miles, but I was very impressed. Guys, you'll notice that I have not said how much this shoe is, because I think if you shop around, you're gonna find some pretty good deals. I'm gonna link to it on Amazon in the show notes below. It retails for $100 on Reebok. So even if you paid full price at $100, this shoe is worth every single penny. But who pays full price? No one pays full price. Look for a coupon. Reebok has offered several. Other places are selling them for a little less expensive. Listen, whatever you get these shoes for, it's worth it. All right, as you can see, I had a pretty big delivery just to get these shoes that fit perfectly. I wasn't gonna take any chances. There is nothing worse than ordering a pair of shoes, finding out they don't fit, and then having to order another pair, and wait a couple more days, right? Waiting sucks. New videos every Monday and Friday. That's it for today. That's all I got for you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're not already, consider subscribing. Be kind, be happy, run well, and I'll see you next time.